that if the Lord said, you can come tonight.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning. Good morning. It is Tuesday. It is Tuesday. Welcome to Tuesday Talks with Tanika. Thank you guys so much for joining in with me today. It is Tuesday. Welcome to Tuesday Talks with Tanika. Thank you for spending a small portion of your Tuesday morning with me today. Tuesday Talks with Tanika. Real quick, if you all can go ahead and hashtag Tuesday Talks with Tanika, hashtag Tuesday Talks with Tanika. Go ahead and share this this message on your page, on your wall. Go ahead and share this with your family, with your friends, those that that you love, those that you care about. I want to go ahead and get into this message, into this topic today, real quick, because I had a message that I wanted to share. I had a way that I wanted to go with this message today, but I can't go that route. I have been rerouted based on the Spirit of God and the way that He's leading me to go this morning. And so I want you all to share this real quick. Go ahead and share this on your page right now. If you can, go ahead and share this, share this, share this, share this. And so real quick, I just want to immediately go in and give you what God has given me to share with you. And so I want to start off with this, with Habakkuk chapter 2. And the Lord answered me and said, write the vision and make it plain upon tables that he may run that readeth it. For the vision is yet for an appointed time, but at the end it shall speak and not lie. Though it tarry, wait for it, but because it shall surely come and it will not tarry. So I just want to drop that in the spirit for those of you that have visions, those of you that have dreams, those of you that have things that God have placed inside of you, things that you have been working on, things that you know that God have been calling you to do, that that you have yet to start on. The time is now for you to do those things. The time is now. The season is now. And God is saying for you to write the vision. Write the vision. The instructions are here. The instructions are here. The instructions have been given to you. So go ahead and make it happen now. Which ties into the message that he's given me. But he dropped that word into my spirit today. And so I had to get that out now. I need you to go ahead and share that to those with those that you know God has been speaking to in this season, with that those of you that know that they have people around them that need them to get out and move. That they have fire under their feet, that they go ahead and need to go ahead and go ahead and do the thing that they've been called to do, because the time is now. The time is now, and I feel like if we don't move now, that we may miss our chances. And you know, sometimes if we don't pick the fruit when it's time to pick the fruit in the season, we might pick bad fruit. And when people eat bad fruit, you can get sick. And so we want to move when it's time to move. And so just want to go ahead and get that out there and share that. Please share that. Go back and read. Go ahead and share this hashtag Tuesday Talks with Tanika. Write the vision. The vision is yet for an appointed time. Write the vision. Make it plain, so that they may, that them that read it may read it and they can run with it. Because though it tarry, it shall surely come. It shall surely come. All right. So we want to go ahead and get into the message that we have for today. The message we want to focus on today is A purpose without a plan is just an agenda. A purpose without a plan is just an agenda. And so, as I was studying over this, I went into the different definitions of an agenda, the different definitions of an agenda, the different definitions of a purpose and a plan. When we think about an agenda is what you would set out to do. By a book definition, an agenda is something to be done, something that you want to get done, and we're going to take our time with this today because I really want to get you to understand exactly the point in this. And we want to go take away some really good detailed information so we can really work this and really grasp the concept of this segment. And so with an agenda, we know that this is something that we would like to get done, right? And so when we have a purpose, our purpose is the reason why we want to get something done. The purpose is the reason why we want to do something. What are our intentions? What is the driving force of what will be our desired results? What is our outcome? What is the purpose behind why we want to do what we're doing? Okay. And our plan, what is our plan? What are the steps that we're going to take in order to get the desired results? What are the things that are going to direct us into the way of our purpose? And what are the steps that we're going to take to get us to our desired end states that's going to get us to the place where we see ourselves or the place that's going to, what are the things that's going to be necessary for us to be able to get to the place where we need to be or to see that product finished? So a purpose without a plan is just an agenda, right? And so if we don't have a plan, but we have a purpose, then all we have is something that we want to get done. And so if we don't have a plan and we don't have a step-by-step direction or a focus point, then all we're doing is really we find ourselves kind of going in circles and kind of finding ourselves with a whole bunch of ideas and a place where nothing is really working for us, where nothing is really working in our favor, and we kind of find ourselves back in the same place where we started, and never really achieving anything, because we have to have a plan of action in order to move forward. If we don't have a plan in place, then we kind of find ourselves questioning ourselves, well, is this gonna work or is this working? And when you have a planning process, you can kind of dissect if this is working, you can take out things, you can add to something, you can kind of do a you can kind of do an analysis, after action review. Well, if this didn't work in this part of the process, I can take this out and I can add this to it, and you can look at your operational part of the process or your logistical piece of the process, and you can set timelines, you can set goals, you can stick to them, you can be able to hold yourself accountable in your planning portion of the process when you add your planning piece of it. So when you have a purpose, you have to have a planning. Your planning piece will hold you accountable and it will push you into being able to meet those goals because you can't reach your goal if you don't plan. You cannot reach your goal if you don't plan. Planning requires you to set timelines. And if you don't have a timeline, you'll never be able to reach your goal because you won't have anything to measure up to. You won't have anything to set yourself up to. You have to have something to reach forward to. A lot of times we say you have to have faith, you have to have faith, Well, we know that you have to have faith in order for things to work, and we can't see the whole picture all the time. But we also know that faith without works is dead, and planning is a part of the work, Planning takes work. It takes thinking to plan. It takes moving to plan. It takes thinking outside of the box to plan. It takes asking questions to plan. We can't sit and think that things are going to happen for us. We have to to go out and get around like-minded people that are doing some of the same things that we're doing. You know, go out and ask people that have been doing it longer than us. You know, hey, how did you get to that place? What did you do? What steps did you take? You know, that can be a part of our planning process. And I've seen sometimes, you know, where some of us may feel inferior to someone that may already be doing what we would like to do, you know, and we may say, well, we don't want to ask questions because we don't want to feel like we're dumb, or we don't know what we're doing, or we don't want to feel like, you know, we're beneath someone else, you know, where that's how we're going to grow. And we'll be surprised how much people would like to help us, you know, help us get to where they are, and help want to bring us along with them, you know, just by asking questions. And I've seen so many ideas and so many purposes, you know, go down the drain and go down in the grave with people because they were afraid to ask questions or afraid to ask for help. And a lot of times we're afraid to ask for help because we think someone wants to steal our idea or steal our vision from us, you know. But like we said before, a couple of weeks ago, you know, what God gave you, you're the only one that can do it that way. You know, God could have given, can give 100 people the same idea or the same type of purpose, but only you can do it the way that God's giving it to you. So it's all going to be original, even if it's derived from the same type of idea. It's all going to be uniquely done because we're all made unique, you know. And so don't feel like someone is going to steal your thunder, you know, because even if it's the same type of project or the same type of idea, only you can do it the way that God's giving it to you, you know. So you're still going to have your little twist on it. You're still going to have, you know, your uniqueness to your project. So don't be afraid to ask for help. Don't be afraid to ask someone else, you know, to give you ideas or to give you insight on how to do something, because that's how we learn. We learn and grow from one another, you know. And so we need to be able to learn from each other and get guidance from other people. There's a lot of knowledge and a lot of wisdom out there in the world. So we need not be afraid of asking for help. There's a lot of competition out there, a lot of people that are trying to go the same place, and sometimes if we're afraid of a competition, you know, we need to just build a little more self-confidence in ourselves and say, you know what? I've got this. I've got this. I can do this. I have what it takes. You know, I am me. You know, I'm my best self. I'm my best self, you know. And we need just to pat ourselves on the back sometimes and encourage ourselves and know that, you know, even if I haven't learned everything I need to know about this project, I'm going to get what I need to get to make it happen, you know. And all of that's a part of the planning process. But we have to be able to plan. We have to be able to plan in order to avoid just having an agenda. That's just like if we go inside of the grocery store, you know, we go inside of the grocery store and we have a purpose for going in a grocery store or any store for that matter. We have a purpose. We know what we want to come out the store with, you know, but we have to go in there. And sometimes if we don't know where something is, we have to ask questions, right? If we don't ask questions, okay, well, where is this product? If we're looking for an electronic product that just came out, if we don't go into the electronic department and ask questions about where this is, we will be wandering around in the store for hours looking for something. And all we have to do is ask the question, you know? And sometimes we do that and we waste years and years and years and years of our time wandering around, you know, in circles and wasting time and wasting energy and wasting money, when all we have to do is take the time to plan out our purpose so that we're not just having a list of an agenda list of ideas of things that we're of something that we want to do, something that we have ideas, a list of things we want to do, you know, and have a reason for what we want to do. We know what we want to do, but we don't have a plan for it. You know, and so that goes back to the scripture that God gave me this morning about writing the vision, writing our vision, making it plain, you know, making it plain. That's the planning. You know, we can't run with something if we don't plan for it. You get it? We can't run with something if we don't plan for it. The planning is our mapping. The planning is our mapping. That's the thing that we take and we go with. You know, we can't follow something that's not laid out properly. You know, and God wants us to follow what he has laid out properly for us, you know, and he's given us the wisdom and the tools of things that's been laid out properly for us. But we have to be able to follow that, you know, we have to be able to follow that and not be fearful, not be so doubtful, not be so prideful, to take that advice, to take that wisdom, to take those resources that he's given us in the earth, to be able to thrive, to be able to thrive, you know, and be our best self and be our best in the kingdom, you know, so that we can be able to give back to those that are around us and be able to give back to those, to make others around us greater, you know? And so I just wanted to drop that in us today, you know, that although we have purpose, we must have a plan so that we don't just have an agenda. We want to have more than just an agenda. You know, a lot of us miss our blessings because we don't want to ask for help. We don't want to ask for help out of fear, out of rejection, you know, and I must admit, you know, I was the same way, you know, out of rejection. I didn't want to be rejected. You know, I have had a really strong fear of rejection, you know, and I thank God for deliverance of that, you know, and I just didn't want to or feel like I was bothering someone, you know, but I thank God for that. And some of us, you know, we're afraid of someone telling us no, you know, but I just want to encourage you all today that if you have a reason to do something, and that is our purpose, a reason to do something, that is our purpose, but you're not working on the way to get it done, which is the plan. The way to get it done is the plan, you know, then essentially we're just working on our intentions. Our intentions is, in other words, our agenda. Today, we want to work on our plan. We want to plan our purpose. We want to begin to execute our plans so that we can reach our highest potentials in whatever areas we set for ourselves. We want to be better. We want to be better. We want to be greater. We want to be our best selves. I want to encourage you today. You know, let's write our visions. Let's make it plain. Let's run with it. You know, though it tarry, we know that it's for an appointed time. And I believe that time is now. I believe that time is now. We want to go ahead and encourage our brothers and our sisters. You know, go ahead and just do your best. Do your best in everything you set out to do. Be confident. Be confident in what God has placed inside of you, in that unique thing that God has placed inside of you. Ask questions. You know, go ahead and tap into those resources. It's all at our disposal. It's all at our disposal. So remember, a purpose without a plan is just an agenda. We don't want to have a list of agendas without a purpose. This is Tuesday Talks with Tanika. I love you guys so much. Go back and read that scripture. I want you all to study it this week. I mean, I know it's going to bless someone. It has blessed me today tremendously. I mean, you guys, go ahead and study that this week. And I believe it's really going to bless someone. It's really going to bless someone. I believe it's speaking to someone today in a mighty way. You know, God has been speaking to you all to go ahead and run with that vision. You know, go ahead and move. God is speaking to someone to go ahead and move. The time is now to move on that vision, to move on that thing that God has placed inside of your spirit, to move on that thing that he is speaking to you. He's placed fire under your feet to go ahead and move those mountains and be your best self. This is Tuesday Talk with Tanika. I love you guys. I will see you next Tuesday at 8:00. Go ahead and share this video. Don't forget the hashtag Tuesday Talks with Tanika. I love you all. Talk to you next Tuesday. Have a great day. Bye-bye.